sisters, sing with your full heart hymn number 224, Christ Arose.
Everyone who's brought food and helped to organize that.
I'd also like to thank everyone who donated so that we have the glorious orchids on the high altar and over on the Easter garden, which was the altar of repose, and it's now doing double duty. And also, before we start, I have to say we have a couple of announcements, which is always a bit of a meh when it comes to a service, but in this case, it is our constitutional, congregational life together. So it's my joy to announce it. Midweek Social continues, and it's on Wednesday at 3:30 p.m. We're not having a break from it in the Easter week. We will continue. The Service of Light is on April the 20th, on Thursday at 5 p.m. And what I do have to tell you is because next week, next Sunday, is our annual congregational meeting, then members, be sure to pick up your business packets today after worship, out in the foyer on the table over on the far side by the lavatory. And mind you pick them up, because there's a lot of stuff in that business meeting which you will need to have read and familiarised yourself beforehand so that the meeting doesn't go on for 3 hours whilst we go over it line by line. So you'll be expected to have had a good look at that. And my final announcement is that on Saturday, April the 29th, we are blessed to have Samson McCormick back with us again. And he'll be giving a comedy concert on April the 29th at 7 p.m. in here. All are welcome. It's free. There will be a love offering for him at some point in the evening. And anybody who's seen him before will know he's great fun. It's really wonderful to have him come.
Please join me in a prayer of confession. Our loving and most gracious God, we come to you in this time as your children. You are the one who calls us into relationship with you, Lord, and we are blessed by that relationship. Lord, we always recognize that there's times when we just don't make the mark. There's times when we don't love our neighbor as we should, that we don't love ourselves as we should. Times when we don't love you as we should. All of these things in very many ways are burdens to us, Lord, and in this time we want to lay those down. Holy Spirit, make each one of us bold to approach your throne of grace where we have nothing to fear from you who love us most. Hear your people now in this time of silence. Amen.
Who ate and drank with him after he arose from the dead. And he commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is one ordained by God to be judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sin through his name. Hear what the Spirit says today.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in the responsive reading of Psalm 118. Oh, give thanks to the Most High, who is good, whose mercy endures forever.
Let Israel now proclaim, God's mercy endures forever.
The Most High is my strength and my song, and has become my salvation.
Joyful shouts of salvation sound from the dance of the righteous.
The right hand of the Most High does mighty deeds. The right hand of the Most High raises up.
The right hand of the Most High does mighty deeds.
I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Almighty.
The Most High has punished me sorely, but has not given me over to death.
Open to me the gates of righteousness, that I may enter and give thanks to God.
This is the gate of the Most High. The righteous shall enter through it.
I will give thanks to you, for you have answered me and have become my salvation.
The stone which the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone.
This is the Almighty's doing, and it is marvelous in our eyes.
This is the day that our God has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it.
Glory be to the Creator, to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
There's a peace I've come to know, though my heart has perished.
Thank you. Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O God.
Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene came to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and the other disciples, the one whom Jesus loved, and said to them, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we do not know where they have laid him." Then Peter and the other disciples set out and went towards the tomb. The two were running together, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent down to look in and saw the linen wrappings lying there, but he did not go in. Then Simon Peter came, following him, and went into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there and the cloth that had been on Jesus' head, not lying with the linen wrappings, but rolled up in a place by itself. Then the other disciple, who reached the tomb first, also went in, and he saw and believed, for as yet they did not understand the scripture, that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples returned to their homes. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had been lying, one at the head and the other at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" She said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." When she had said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? For whom are you looking?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned and said to him in Hebrew, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not hold on to me, because I have not yet ascended to the Father. But go to my brothers and say to them, I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced this to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and she told them that he had said these things to her. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Mourning is eventually joined again by joy. despair need not have the last word. Our crimes are expunged, or sometimes, when the light changes, we see that they were never crimes at all. The dry and cold winter soil exhales with life in spring. Hatred can indeed turn to love. Anger turns to reconciliation. We know these things are almost truisms, but they seldom comfort us when we were swallowed up in grief. It is only by the light of day that the grave pit is shown to be shallow and not deep. Bishop Bickersteth wrote a great epic poem called The Shadowed Home and the Life Beyond in the 19th century. And the only bit of it which I can remember, or which really spoke to me, was this one line: "We shall know what the darkness discovers if the grave pit be shallow or deep." "It is shallow," says Easter. "It is deep," cries Good Friday. But it is both. We grow taller as our souls are more fully made. And as we grow taller, the pit grows less. Eventually, it's a mere dip in the endless green of the spring hills. Those hills represent our eternal home, and we will then be far too lofty to fear the things that we feared before, and the remembrance of those terrors will no longer terrify us. Every tear will be wiped away, and the rising sun shall never set. Indeed, the sun never really does set. It burns on in glory as we pass our brief day, whether we see it or not, whether our world has turned into night or not, the sun still burns on in glory. The sun has risen. He has risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Mercy, I hear his voice. Now is the time for our community prayer. If you have any prayers that you would like expressed silently, raise your hand. Any thanksgivings or prayers for healing?
Hallelujah.
Let us pray. O Lord, thank you for redeeming us through your Son, Jesus Christ. Help us to go forward now that he is risen, and take his story, our story, throughout the land, through to everyone we know, to everyone we meet. Help the world to know you are the Messiah. We ask for prayers today for Thomas Reinberg. He's asking for healing of his right foot, which has an infection after surgery. Also, lift up Marty. She has back pain today and not feeling very good. Also, we ask for our church leaders and all those today who are out there passing the word along that Jesus has risen.
Have Kevin Sanders Nelson
singing a solo for us, they could not. Please come forward. beauty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, almighty and eternal Father, and in these days of Easter to celebrate with joyful hearts the memory of your wonderful works. For by the mystery of his passion, Jesus Christ, your risen Son, has conquered the powers of death and hell and restored in men and women the image of your glory. He has placed them once more in paradise and opened to them the gate of life eternal. And so in the joy of this Passover, earth and heaven resound with gladness, whilst angels and archangels and the power of all creation sing forever the hymn of your glory. Saying, take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And so, Almighty God, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sin of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this service, a sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we in the company of all our beloved who have passed before us and indeed all the saints may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord.
By whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be yours, Almighty Creator, forever and ever. Amen.
Let us now sing together at the Agnus Dei, the Lamb of God. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are those who are asked to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
Here in the Metropolitan Community Church of Coachella Valley, we practice an open communion, as indeed we do in MCCs all over the world. That means you don't have to be a member of this church to come forward and receive communion. You just have to wish for it in your heart. Please know that on the right-hand side there will be alcoholic communion wine, on the left-hand side non-alcoholic communion wine. Just indicate which you prefer according to your tradition. And if you'd rather receive a blessing rather than communion, then come up like this and we'll give you a blessing. There'll also be a prayer partner over there by the piano and one over there by the Easter garden. And they're there for anything that may be on your heart. If you have healing that you require, they also have oil of anointing. They can anoint you. And if you have a thanksgiving or if you have a concern for someone else, go and take up their time, because their time is your time. And you can keep them there for the rest of the morning if you want. But please, communion is served, the table is set, and the meal is prepared. Come forward. Yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, Alpha and Omega, all time belongs to him and all ages. To him be glory and power through every age and forever.
Yeah.
risen.
He is risen indeed. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
And once more with gusto. Thine is the glory.